I need your advice regarding janitrol furnace problems.
Their heat pumps need the evaporator coils replaced all the time.
I have only the janitrol furnace, not a heat pump.
All of Janitrol's motherboards go out before they are even 5 years old. That's ACs, heat pumps and furnaces.
That can get expensive, though I think the motors and heat exchanger cost about as much.
Heat exchangers hardly ever go out. Some brands even have a lifetime warranty on the heat exchanger, though not Janitrol.
All I need is a warranty that covers what breaks when I'm still able to remember how much it cost new.
The warranty only covers parts, not labor.
That's standard for HVAC these days. If you did have a heat pump or AC, the warranty would not cover the refrigerant no matter the brand.
There are jokes that Janitrol counts as high efficiency because it breaks down so often.
I just want to know what the major problems are, and if possible, how to fix them.
If the control panel simply has flashing lights you can't decipher, shut it all down, including the gas, then bring it all back up and see if it works right.
You're telling me to reboot my furnace?
That might fix what is wrong with the control panel.
I have something else wrong, since the furnace is cycling.
Since it may be overheating, you may need to clean the flame sensor or even the burners because the interior gets too hot when the sensors say it reaches temp.
That's at least something I can do myself.
Another possibility is setting the furnace to fan only and letting that run for a while, cooling it off, and then turning on the heat.
That only says that the problem is airflow related or motor related if it shuts down before I turn on the heat.
Yes, and if it shuts down after you turn on the heat, you'll know the cycle time to tell the repair tech. And you can watch to see if the problem is condensate buildup putting out the flame or overheating after having dried and cooled it by running the fan.
So this is process of elimination.
And by running it without heat for a while, you can see if the lights flash to say the pressure switch has problems or the gas valve is acting up. Instead of the light show equivalent of a blue screen of death to report multiple issues.
If that were clearly the case, I'd know the solution, call the repairman.